In this lecture, we will look at two examples based on sea level observations, for which we will step by step set up the functional model. This figure shows 10 years of monthly tide gauge observations in IJmuiden, the Netherlands. From the graph, you may be able to tell that the sea level rise seems to follow a linear trend, and in addition to that, there is an annual oscillation. But we will ignore this for the moment. Our goal is thus to set up the functional model where we consider only the linear trend of sea level rise for now, as indicated by the green line. As a first step, we need to identify the observations, the knowns, and the unknown parameters. Obviously, the observations are the tide gauge measurements, which are taken once a month. The times at which these observations are taken are treated as known, and therefore deterministic parameters, and they are expressed in years. What are then the unknown parameters for this linear trend model? Firstly, one unknown is the initial sea level at T0, as indicated along the vertical axis. Secondly, the parameter that we are really interested in, namely the change of sea level, delta L, over a certain time interval. We will call this the rate of change, R, and it is expressed in millimeters per year. We now have all the ingredients we need to set up the observation equations, which we will derive first for a single observation at time ti. The expected value of this observable will be equal to the initial sea level L0 plus the rate of change R multiplied by the time interval between ti and t0. As we have monthly observations, for the first observation, the time interval will therefore be 1/12, since our time is in units of 1 year. For the second observation, it is 2/12, and so on and so forth. The system of m observation equations becomes as follows, where on each row we recognize the observation equations for the time ti. For instance, here we highlighted the equation for the second observation. This system can be rewritten as a matrix vector product, separating the knowns and unknowns, as shown on the right-hand side of the equation. So, this is our final functional model, where we distinguish the expectation of the vector of observables, the design matrix A, and the vector X with unknown parameters. As a second example, assume now we would again have 10 years of monthly tide gauge observations, but now in the absence of a linear trend in sea level rise. Here, we are only interested in this annual signal, modeled by a sign as shown by the green line. Compared to the previous example, an additional known parameter is now the period T, since we are looking for an annual signal. Hence, capital T will be equal to 1 year. The unknown parameters are then again the sea level at T0, which we will call L0, plus the amplitude A of the annual signal, indicated on the left-hand side of the graph. The observation equation for this model becomes the sum of the unknown initial sea level, L0, plus the sine term multiplied with the unknown amplitude. Since the period T is equal to 1, the observation equation simplifies to this one, based on which the functional model follows as this system of equations, where each row is equal to the observation equation shown above with corresponding time interval. This can also be written as a matrix vector product as shown on the right-hand side, such that we again recognize the different constituents of the functional model. You will now derive the functional model where you will be considering the combination of a linear trend and an annual signal, as shown with the green graph in this plot. And this is one of the exercises. And now that we know how the functional model is defined and can be set up for a particular estimation problem, in the following lecture we will look at specific properties of the functional model.